I'm quite sure that you've heard of Shakespeare, and you might have seen something in the theatre, one of some of his plays, Hamlet or Othello. Maybe you've seen some of the films, Romeo and Juliet, perhaps. But I doubt you know very much about the sonnets. Now, the sonnets are the poems that he's written over 400 years ago when Shakespeare was alive, and he wrote about 154 of these sonnets. Now, we're not going to do all of them, of course, but you might wonder, what is actually a sonnet? Well, a sonnet is just a regular poem, but with a difference. And the difference lies within the structure of how the sonnet is built. So if you write poetry, you probably have written some poetry, perhaps, in your free time. But a sonnet is a very clearly structured poem of 14 lines. All these lines have got 10 syllables each. So you can probably now realize why it was so difficult to write so many of them, and that's probably why he's still one of the greatest sonneteers in the world. And Sonnet 17 is about the power of poetry, and how whatever you write down is still worthy, you know, after so many years, because obviously, you know, people still might read it. In our case, of course, we're still sitting here discussing the sonnet, so he was right. And he says, who will believe my verse, who will believe this sonnet that I'm writing now, if I tell the world about your beauty and your special parts, your characteristics, who will believe? Who will believe my verse in time to come, if it were filled with your most high deserts? Though yet heaven knows it is but as a tomb which hides your life and shows not half your parts. If I could write the beauty of your eyes and in fresh numbers number all your graces, the age to come would say, this poet lies. Such heavenly touches ne'er touched earthly faces. So should my papers, yellowed with their age, be scorned like old men of less truth than tongue, and your true rights be termed a poet's rage and stretched meter of an antique song. But were some child of yours alive that time, you should live twice, in it and in my rhyme. Believe my verse in time to come, if it were filled with your most high deserts. Though yet heaven knows it is but as a tomb which hides your life and shows not half your parts. If I could write the beauty of your eyes and in fresh numbers number all your graces, the age to come would say, this poet lies. Such heavenly touches ne'er touched earthly faces. So should my papers, yellowed with their age, be scorned like old men of less truth than tongue, and your true rights be termed a poet's rage and stretched meter of an antique song. But were some child of yours alive that time, you should live twice, in it and in my rhyme. And we hope to see you soon. Thank you very much.